everyone. I'm Julie Strauss, the General Manager of Power Platform Developer and Admin Experiences. Having a low-code strategy is critical for every organization as it empowers business agility for years to come. In fact, in the next 5 years, 500 million more apps will be created. That's more than all apps built in the last 40 years, according to IDC. There simply aren't enough professional code-first developers to go around for the volume of work ahead of to modernize businesses. However, the good news is that low-code technology is here to empower more people to create apps regardless of coding ability. Microsoft looks at low-code not as a collection of discrete applications, but as a platform with an end-to-end portfolio of tools that are powerful alone and even better together. A platform that brings together all you need to innovate and automate your business securely, seamlessly, and quickly, enabling everyone from citizen to pro developers. This release wave builds on our commitment to create applications and experiences that add value to every role. This by breaking down silos between data and insight and people. Let's take a look at some of the new capabilities. Power Apps is focusing on reducing risk for organizations with advanced governance capabilities, ensuring every easy onboarding and use of low-code capabilities in a manageable way for the organization at scale. With this release, developers will be able to build and reimagine and deploy their business applications through an intuitive natural language conversation. Makers will get intelligent insights and analytics through a conversational chat experience. They can use natural language to create queries that will help them create the app, all with the help of an AI assistant. Power Pages continue to invest in bringing more out-of-the-box capabilities to support the low-code and no-code development, as well as professional developers. With the launch of new solution-based application lifecycle management capabilities, both professional developers and low-code makers now can utilize solutions to migrate their website configurations from one environment to another. With virtual tables and Cloudflow integration, Power Pages can now connect to your external data sources and services seamlessly, enabling both low-code makers and pro developers to build amazing user experiences. Power Automate is releasing new capabilities to simplify creating new flows and describing them in natural language. This, with other experience improvements for creating and authoring flows, means it will be easier for everyone and every new user to get started. Power Platform is taking no-code AI to the next level with new GPT-enhanced capabilities for AI Builder. You can now harness the power of cutting-edge technology and embed intelligent AI into Power Automate. Amazing improvements include introducing work queues where automatable tasks can be viewed and managed together, as well as providing simpler connectivity to a machine for desktop flows, eliminating the need for additional installs and password management. Power Virtual Agents offer a new unified authoring canvas that is Microsoft's single conversational AI studio for all bot building needs. Now enhanced with GPT, Power Virtual Agents bots immediately useful and are the fastest way for organizations to reduce costs. With the continuing integration with Microsoft bot framework capabilities and Azure Cognitive Services, bot creators, from subject matter experts to developers, are empowered to begin building today with the public preview. The unified authoring canvas will be generally available in this wave. Now, let's take a look at a real customer scenario. Pacific Gas and Electric, PG&E, is a San Francisco-based utility company that provides natural gas and electricity to more than 5.2 million households in Northern California. In 2001, the company embarked on an ambitious program to leverage automation and citizen development to alleviate cost pressures and eliminate redundant and manual processes from the daily work of its 32,000 team members. The answer was Microsoft Power Platform, which deployed to help PG&E rationalize its automation tool footprint, consolidate on a single platform, and replace legacy applications and solutions. In a moment, Miti will show us some of the new features in the 2023 release wave for Power Platform, which allows companies like PG&E to provide a much broader set of capabilities to drive digital transformation across the entire organization. Miti, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Julie. PG&E has a responsibility to assist local areas in rebuilds and continued operations during catastrophes like wildfires and earthquakes. In complex scenarios like these, providing a quick experience for end users so that they can easily search for outages using their home address is critical. This is when Power Pages comes into play. With this new release, makers can securely call any Power Automate Cloud Flow from Power Pages UI, thus providing the ability to connect to any data source. With the updated VS Code for Web experience, when makers open VS Code for Web to call Cloud Flows from Power Pages UI, they can now edit all the components of their Power Pages website in one go, rather than going page by page. The necessary JavaScript can be easily added in the UI to call these Cloud Flows. The next step is to provide an experience for users to report an outage using this website. This data is stored in a SQL server hosted by PG&E. Whenever a customer reports an issue, we want to make sure that it will directly be created in this SQL server. To make this integration with external data sources even simpler, we are adding first-class support for virtual tables. With this capability, we will enable the integration of external enterprise data with Microsoft Dataverse without the need for data duplication. First, we create a virtual table in Dataverse, which connects to the reporting SQL server. Then, from the data workspace, we can see that the virtual table connected to SQL server appears just like any Dataverse table. We can now quickly create a form for this table and embed it in the Power Pages web page using the out-of-box form functionality. It is amazing how easy it is to connect to a SQL server table and reuse all of the out-of-box functionality of Power Pages. This website content is now ready to be promoted from developer environment to production. To do this, makers can now utilize the new Power Pages solution-aware ALM capabilities. They can export all the changes in a solution and then import the solution to their production environment. Site config has now become portable. Let's now take a look at how PG&E customers can self-serve information and report outages with Power Virtual Agents. With this new release, Power Virtual Agents allow organizations such as PG&E to build bots with GPT using company-related resources. Organizations can now easily connect their bots to their websites with just a link. All they need to do to create a bot is to specify a single web address. Power Virtual Agents will search this web portal using Bing and summarize relevant results using GPT. How amazing is that? Now that this bot is created, we can go into settings, check the topics that have been created, and simply turn off those that we don't want to use, and we're now ready to test. We can ask questions like, where can we find out about scheduled power reports? This generates responses automatically based on the information found on our website. We can also check to see if there are any electrical outages in our area, and we can be very specific here. See how the bot understands that we are asking about a particular area having an electrical outage. This is the power of bots with GPT being able to generate back the response without us having to author a topic here. And once this bot is ready, modifying dialogues has never been easier. Customers can now use natural language to build topics. With this release, we will enable makers to design and modify bot dialogue with natural language. Bot builders can effortlessly describe their desired bot design and GPT will automatically transform it into a topic that can continuously be refined and optimized through the use of natural language processing. In this case, what we're going to do is create a topic that allows a user to report a power outage and collect the user's name, phone number, street address, and a description of the urgency of the problem, whether it is critical, high, medium, or low. We'll give this a name, and there we go. The topic is created and is already pre-populated with the trigger phases and conversation path. All the different selections that the user can have are here, as well as a summary of the information that's collected. We can also select just a specific node that we want to target and change it using natural language. This allows us to be specific about where we want a change to be applied. Let's see how Power Automate can help the quality department of PG&E stay on top of customer feedback. The objective is to have a daily recap of customer feedback, generate an email report, and push this data to an internal site without API connectivity. Let's see how Power Automate can achieve all of this with the new release. We are going to create a flow based on the description, once a week, get all the feedback from a table in Dataverse, and send them by email. With Power Automate, organizations can easily get started building new automations. All that is needed is a simple description of the cloud flow in everyday natural language. Thanks to OpenAI, we can easily add an action to generate a summary of all the feedback received from customers. Using the provided template of instructions, we can prompt the model to work the way we choose. Whether it is summarizing text, analyzing sentiment, or extracting key information from customer feedback, getting started is simple and easy. And we can even craft our own set of specific instructions for greater customizability. In order to make sure that the generated summary is good enough, it is crucial to incorporate human-in-the-loop validation. This ensures that GPT acts responsibly with the desired intent. To do this, we can now send GPT-generated output to an approval flow before it is automatically processed. Some automations require an RPA bot to automate manual tasks. Here, we want to store the customer feedback in a web form that stores it into an internal data store. RPA automation requires a bot machine to run, and with the latest hosted RPA solution, we provide hosted machine to build, test, and run automations from within Power Automate portal, thus eliminating the need for customer-managed machines. Users can select a default VM image, a custom VM image, or connect to a customer VNet for access to on-prem resources. Once the hosted machine is provisioned, the user can directly launch into the Windows machine from Power Automate portal. The hosted machine has been pre-configured to connect to the environment and is ready to go. It's time to create a new desktop flow. We configure an action to launch an instance of Microsoft Edge with the web form and automatically complete this form. We can now go back to the cloud flow and add an additional step. If the approval is received, a desktop flow action will run on the same hosted machine to add the feedback into a web form, and now we are all set. Finally, let's take a look at how Power Apps enables PG&E's teams to inspect facilities to quickly detect and resolve outages. During power outages, PG&E's electric overhead facilities undergo specific inspections. The team's primary task is to check into the site and inspect the various parts. Let's see how organizations like PG&E can build new apps simply by describing what they need in natural language. With this release, the Power Apps Maker portal now has this big text box saying we can use everyday words to describe the app we want to build. How exciting! We type in site inspection details, and a table is immediately generated. We review the columns and see that the table even has sample data that matches our scenario. We have all heard the phrase, there's an app for that. To build the right app, though, one of the most crucial steps is to design and build the right table. Now, with Copilot for Power Apps, everyone can create those tables using natural language. Just describe what you want, and Power Apps will create it for you in seconds. This table looks good, but it seems to be missing something. Since we're not quite sure what it is, let's ask our co-pilot to give some suggested columns for this table. The columns that we get in response look good, so we go ahead and add them. Looking at the table, we see that a location column, which is very important to define a site being inspected, is missing. Let's go ahead and ask our co-pilot to add a location column and populate it with data. At this point, what we have looks great. So let's go ahead and click Create App, which in a few seconds will create a fully functional, modern application using the data that we just defined. Looking at homepage, it seems that it allows our application users to interact with this data using natural language. This is awesome, because not only do we as makers have an intelligent co-pilot help us build the app, but we can also give the same GPT-enabled experience to our users. Let's see another amazing addition to this release. Here, we are looking at an app for scheduling service visits. Looking at the app in the design tool on desktop, it looks good. But our frontline workers are going to be using this app on a few different devices. How will it look for them? We could publish this app and then run it on a different device, but that takes time. And what if we don't have the right device handy? Enter the device preview feature. This is a brand new way to make sure that an app looks good on mobile without ever having to leave the Power Apps Design Studio. We have just seen some of the new features in the 2023 release wave for Power Platform, which allows companies like PG&E to provide a much broader set of capabilities to drive digital transformation across the organization. Back to you, Julie.
Thank you, Miti. You've just seen only a few of our fantastic new capabilities, including building new apps just by describing in natural language what you need with Power Apps, describing a flow and building it in seconds with an AI-based co-pilot with Power Automate, improved code editing reliability and enhanced page preview experience with VS Code for web with Power Pages, as well as the support to allow customers to create bot and specify a single web address with Power Virtual Agents. But that is not all. We have over 100 features coming with this release between April and September. Thank you for your interest, and I hope you enjoyed the summary of what is coming next with our October wave for Power Platform. To learn more, head to our release notes and release web videos.